right, our last group of the night is our Symphonic One group. I'm starting with announcement because the first piece we're doing isn't something you're going to go whistling out of this place with. Part of a music education is giving them kind of a little bit of everything, from way back to the beginning all the way to the new. Well, this piece is on the newer side, the angry side, matches some of their personalities a little bit. So here we go. Here is the first movement to Trittico. It's fun, right? Yep. No other way around. Music speaks for itself. All right. Real quick, I just wanted to take a moment to recognize some of our participants. So, I know we always mention this, but we get to this time of year and there's more things going on than during marching band. And so, marching band, everybody's doing the same thing. So, we get to this time of the year, we've got three concert bands, two jazz bands, two performing color guards that go out and travel, and it's just busy, busy, busy. And so it's awesome because, like, we're right in the middle of testing season, and these kids have committed to, like, doubling and tripling, quadrupling 50 million things all at once. And so they're getting it done, and they're being here. So real quick, I want to recognize some folks. First group I want to recognize is all of our all-county participants that participated in all-county band. Could you please stand? See, they like the attention. I just wanted to see how long it takes. All right. Okay, and then the other group that I want to recognize, all our folks that participated in a solo or an ensemble at District or State, please stand. It's one of those things, like when we do speeches in college or we have to get up and give a class presentation, it's something that builds them as people to communicate and be a person, that sort of thing. And so just encourage, like just riding on what Mr. Schulz said, it's if you don't see your kids standing, then ask them to do it. If they're standing, make them keep doing it. Because this is one of the things as an individual that's going to make them stronger and better to contribute to the whole that we have. So thank you for that. Next, I want to welcome to the stage my colleague, rock star, Mr. Schulz. Thank you. higher than I thought it would come out. Our next piece is a special piece. We this year have had a clarinetist that has come in and worked with all three of our band classes, coached them, give them guidance, and all that stuff. She's been great. She's done some solo and ensemble work with the kids, been doing some private lessons. It's also a neat honor because Dr. Kindy was in my first graduating class at Spruce Creek High School of students that I saw through. She went to Stetson to get her bachelor's in music. She then went straight on to Michigan to get her master's, and she just recently is graduating this week and walking with Eastman School of Music up in Rochester, New York. We had talked about doing this together early on when we started into the year, and I thought how neat, because Dr. Kindy started just like a middle school beginner. During her freshman year, we used to do some coaching sessions, and she would come in, and I'd ask her, how did she count that in music? And she said, up, down, up, down, up, down. and so she's awesome, and it's great to have her here. And so let's welcome her to the stage, Ms. Vaclav.
Thank you.
Let's give Dr. Kindy one more round of applause. All right, now's that time for a few recognitions. First, I'm going to do some thank yous, and then I will do our senior folks. First, I want to thank the auditorium, Mr. Nieberlin, Mr. Siever, Mary Stetler, all the student staff that are here helping. Just let's give them a hand. Just recently, the auditorium, the Flagler Auditorium and Arts and Education grants that they provide just recently provided three of our students with support to go to summer music camps, and also provided funding for us to bring somebody to our new student leadership team to do a day-long leadership camp with the students. So let's give them a hand. I want to thank again Mr. Rich. Can you come to the stage real quick? I'm going to brag on Mr. Rich for a second. He's been a delight to have here. It's been like having a third band director, and so it's really neat when they go through their college ed program, and then they come out on the other side very prepared and very eager and very ready. And as soon as he came in, he was eager to get to work. He pitched in wherever. We asked him just right from the get-go, and the kids really gravitated to him, and he's just been wonderful to have here. So let's give him another round. I want to thank all of you, our parents, for getting your kids to all of our rehearsals, and it's a lot of stuff, and preparing that stuff, just providing that support, instruments, reeds, valve oil, headaches, sorrow, tears, joy, all the above. And so we thank you. I want to thank our band booster parents who have volunteered their time, and both whether you're a board member or whether you're just volunteering your time throughout, we thank you. And so our band booster board members, real quick, can we bring the lights up real quick? Could y'all please stand? Our board members, let's give them a round of applause. I know they don't like me doing that, but there's a lot of behind-the-scenes stuff that one, two of us, three of us can't do, and so we thank all of those who help out. People who are not here tonight but are just part of our team, Miss Lauren Albert, Ruth Albert, Billy Dean, Miss Daniels was here in the fall. She's actually finally going home. She fell and broke her hip. She's actually just now going home today from rehab. And then Miss